you have a dream, and I'm a great believer, if you don't have dreams, then dreams don't come true. Here we are. Utopia has happened. The opportunity came along, so you either grasp it with both hands and go with it, or you say, let's wait till next year. Whereas St Cadoc's, we want to do this, and we just have to deal with what's been put in front of us. My name's Mark Thompson. I was the chairman at St Cadoc's Youth Club for 15 years.
Today's a wonderful opportunity. First team, first game, the first ever fielded senior team at St Cadoc's Youth Club. I'm Brendan, I'm a Janny at St Cadoc's. It was a school team developed in a brand new primary school in 1978 by the then Janny, Mr. David Jones. Mr. Jones led the football team for decades. Primary sevens went down to primary threes.
I got involved with the club about 15 years ago when my son, Stephen, at that time was in primary three. I quickly saw the potential that the club had, and I started then to take it beyond the boundaries of the school, and I opened it up to all kids. We grew from strength to strength. We developed our first 11-a-side team.
We've got players in the matchday squad today who have played for St Cadoc's, who have left St Cadoc's. We didn't have an adult team for them actually to play in. So this is a fantastic opportunity to keep some of the talent we already have within the club.
Myself and Brendan Boyle had a conversation about 5 or 6 years ago, and this was a kind of, this was the dream, this was utopia.
Our original plan this year was that we were going to field an amateur team and apply again to one of the amateur leagues. So when we learned that access to this league was subject to an application form, we thought, who doesn't love a goal? Who doesn't love excitement? Who doesn't love and benefit from the quest for success? West of Scotland League and the Lowland League that was overseeing the applicants and things gave us some pretty testing, demanding questions. Not least, you've never fielded an adults team, guys. How are you going to do it?
I pressed it up, I picked the pressure off you.
The club has ambitions. It's been very ambitious since the start, but I would be lying if I sat here and said that I thought one day St Cadoc's would be part of a professional setup within the Scottish Football Association. It's pride for me, but it's also pride for the club. Once the referee blows that whistle, then I'll believe we're here.
Mark texted me to say he put on the TV one night, saw St Cadoc's in the West of Scotland League and started crying. And of course that's emotional. That's a wonderful thing to be part of.
It's an emotional moment for anybody involved with St Cadoc's, but unfortunately there's only a few of us here today. So I think it'll be a bigger emotional moment once we get the crowds back in and get the St Cadoc's family here with us. It means everything. It's something I've put 15 years of my life into, something I feel passionate about.
The pandemic brings many difficulties, and we believe it's an opportunity to show the resilience of the club and part of the resilience that we hope we engender within everybody connected to the club, that despite these grave difficulties, that we can still have time for a wee bit of fun. We're now part of the Scottish football pyramid. Why don't we go and try and scale it?